Italian reads, O maiden candore, di capolere, ed un bel cuore la fedeltà. Un orma sola che se riceve, tutta ne vola la sua beltà. And that repeats that. So, see how we do it with the Italian. Oh, bell, 1, 2, 3, and. Everybody, two short exercises today, only four measures in length for each of them. Wow. Let's sneak through. There we go. And the first one, whoops, sorry about that. First one is in 6/8, so two beats to a measure with the dotted quarter note getting a beat. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So here we go, and da, da, 1, 2, here we go. Da 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 da. Nice quick short note at the end. One more time. Two, here we go. Da 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 da. All right. The second one is in cut time, 2/2, so the half note gets the beat. So we get some half note triplets in there, followed immediately by some quarter note triplets. We'll go about this tempo. So this is the half note. 1, 2, here we go. Da 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 da. So we go all sorts of different rhythms here. Ready? 1, and here we go. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. All right, and then a little sight singing in C minor, la, singing la ti do re mi fa si la. Ready and da, la ti do re mi fa si. La, here we go. Ready? 1, 2, 3, and la di do re do di. If this la, la, where is fa? La, fa, la, fa, mi, re, do, ti, la. Very good. Pass that back into the middle. And take out the Vaughan Williams period. Here we go. So, alto, start us off. So here we are in 4-2. Remember, half note getting the beat. 2, 3, and 4. To the little solo section. Very good. 4 now at least, let's not take the pianissimo too seriously. Knock it up just a little bit so we can really hear. Yes. So, yes. So yes, that alto note is still part of the chorus there.
The first note on in measure 15 is still
in measure 15 is still up the chorus. So ends with the song. And altos will then come off right on big beat 3. Song. Use that beat to put the N on. Sopranos, your first entrance is a nasty page turn. Give yourself a note. I have written in my music, you know, soprano, one beat rest or a half beat rest. So I would put in a note to turn your page ahead of time, and you're the first entrance that comes on the offbeat. Up until that point, the entrances have all come right on the beat, and this one comes on the end of one. Good, that much again. Key, 3 and 4, alto. Thank you. Good. Sopranos. Put a little bit of an accent on your entrance right before letter A in measure, pick up to measure 11. Just so we really feel where that is. Basses come in with a nice strong key right before that. So use the K to really let it come through. Same thing in measure 7. And for all parts, use the K to really key, set where the note is. Are there any note questions in this opening little bit? Yes. Yeah, that's really the only place for it, unfortunately.
Right, so how does not emphasize the
so use that decrescendo to bring yourself down. Because there's really nowhere else to breathe, unfortunately. Then when we get to where we just ended, measure 15, solo voices, or it's a small ensemble, sing measures 15 through measure 30 and 31 on page 7. All of that is solo stuff. And then altos come back in at the tail end of the solo things in measure 30. So let us pick it up right there at measure 30.
Thank you.
And he really does write out that last note. He gives no fermata. He writes out how long he wants it to be. We can make much more of the places where suddenly we get loud. For instance, the top of page 9, measure 40, where suddenly we've come from being piano and starting in 38 have a big crescendo, or actually starts in the pickup to 38, with altos, tenors, and basses, and suddenly we're at forte in the middle of 40, and then immediately come back down. It's as though we can't control ourselves and just come through and then all of a sudden need to pull it back down. Let's go. We'll start on big beat 2 in measure 28. And at the top of page 6, it should not read 21, it should read 26. Measure 26 there. Sorry about that. And we'll start where the little small ensemble finishes up with their Christe and Le. And this is the second half, or the second big beat of measure 28. And then altos, you come in 30. And 1. Alto. Good. The next time we work on that, we will link it with the middle section using the solo parts as well, so we get a feel for how it all hangs together. Very good, though. In pace. That's next. And we're going to start in measure 58. We're going to start with altos and basses. It's 61. Sorry. 61. 58 is where the last phrase ends. Long, long. And again, in a very big tune, one and two and those two parts again, altos and basses. One and two, alto. Good, and be careful, altos in measure 67. First note way down to an E flat there.
Oh, Spirit.
Sopranos and tenors. Three and four and da. Just be ready for that page turn, and all of a sudden there are 16th notes for the first time in the piece. Leaving them till the last four measures.
You better show off those tenors.
Same thing, sopranos and tenors. One and two and soprano.
So
good altos and tenors. And sopranos and basses. One and two and ready? Here we go. Song with altos. One and two and I'm sorry. I just said to do sopranos and basses. My mistake, sorry. One and two, soprano. All four parts, starting back at 61. One and alto. And we won't slow down at all going into the cadence. We'll charge right ahead. Granted, it's only at a very, very slow tempo, but we won't slow down any further. Back to the very beginning. One and good. One more time. Even though it's slow, think crisp rhythms. Make the rhythms nice and crisp, even though we're at a slow tempo. One and two and. then you'll hear a short intonation that ends with "We escom," which is the same F that you begin on altos and there's another intonation that ends the same way. Requiescam and alto. So we end with a nice Gloria, which should have just a little bit more feeling of presence there. Starting back in measure 61. Yes?
Pronunciation question. In the alto part, it first happens in 51. Because you don't see the rest of the whole word, is that a T or a T? So
Tatsi on them. Yes, so the TI becomes a TS, C. Dormi tatsi on them. That happens in all parts, in that little bit that begins in measure 48, I guess it is. Yes. All right. So that sort of gives us a feel of how the whole piece hangs together. The intonations are quite short. in ipsum dormiam et requiescam. Very short intonations. The second one is almost the same, just a little bit shorter, ends the same way. And both of them end on an F, which is the note that the altos then begin on each time after the intonation, if I remember correctly. So, all right. Unser Keiner lebet im Selbe. And there is some question I know about the recording and the tablet, or recording on the Padlet. And, I will work on all of that, but for right now, and figure out exactly what is up with that. But we'll be working from what we have right now. Some of you have said that the recording seems to go on longer than we have music for. They've obviously gotten carried away about something. I don't know what that is. But I will check that to make sure that we have the correct recording to work off of. So again, with the half note getting the beat here. Unser Ka, and just on Da for now. We will add the German the next time we do this. And I will get onto our Padlet the recordings of the German. And for a few of you who are doing the hymn, I will also get to you a recording of the French that that entails. So, right at the beginning. One and two and da. Good. And altos, remember, in measure two, there's an E natural. The A flat in measure three. It sort of wants to be, or feels like it wants to be, an E flat, but it's not. Here we go. One and two and. And bass. Da, 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 da. Good, good. Backing up to measure eight, pick up into nine, just tenors and altos. To the bottom of the first page. Da, 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 da. One and tenor. Da, alto. Da, 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 da. Good. Soprano one and soprano two. Up at the top of page two, measure 11. One and two.
da da da.
Soprano twos, remember that there are lots of places where suddenly you are up on top. So don't all of a sudden think, why are they singing lower than me? They're the ones. All five parts, starting with tenors, pick up to measure nine. Da, da, and da. Da, 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 da. Section that we just did is really just one statement. It just goes on quite some time. Altos and basses, starting in measure 18. Alto and bass. One and two and. Da 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 da. Nice job on the nice low F there, altos. Yes?
There was a measure 21. Some people were getting that on E flat.
Next one is a flat in measure 22. Yes. Tenors and basses.
The reason the tenors were a flat is we were missing two pages.
Oh.
It goes from page 3 to page 6.
No. Oh. We'll need to grab the. Do you want to check the boxes there?
I mean, I know we're super fast.
It's a little too fast. How many people have that problem?
It may just be the two copies that went out today.
Yeah. From 3 to 6, Bob?
Yes.
Let's see. I think it's just two, yeah.
You only have 3 to 6? Anybody else have 3 and 6? We can't hear you. What?
Altos, we just did it, so they were there. Let's skip the tenor part right now and do the soprano 1 and 2. All the music is down here, Linda.
You don't need tenors anyway.
So soprano 1 and soprano 2, measure 18. One and two and one and da 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 yum pa da dum bum dum dee and one da 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 da. More time, back in measure 18. And one, and. Let's all 5 parts, and then we'll come back to the tenor part when we get there. Sorry about that. I'm not sure where they went, but.
They went, did you say all the music was downstairs?
No, it's upstairs, but I thought I had brought all of it down. Here we go, I think. Oh, okay, so the Padlet is probably okay then. So, since we now have it, let's do the tenor and basses starting at 18. The tenors have the tricky entrance since we've got the offbeat. Da da da. 1 and 2, tenor bass. 1. Da 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 da. Two and da 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 five parts, starting in measure 18. One and altos, da, da, da. It push us all the way through to the end there. Backing up to page 5, measure 39, we go from this very almost frantic eighth note thing to whole notes and half notes. But it still has to have a feeling of moving forward. And then we slowly build back up, but we never get quite as frantic with the eighth notes. We just keep with quarter notes as we build forward. So, starting with the pickup to measure 42, soprano 1 and 2. One and da.
Da, da, da. Da, da.
Here we go, starting again. Pick up to measure 42.
Da, da, da.
One and soprano one.
Da, da, da.
And tenors. starting at measure 42.
Oh. Tenors, altos.
One and two and tenor.
Da, 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 da.
Anytime anyone has something like what the altos have there in measure 48, where we get that offbeat entrance against everyone else on the beat, just a little bit of an accent. So we really feel it come in. Starting with everyone, all five parts in measure 39, halfway through 39.
Soprano one, soprano two.
One and two and da.
Da.
Soprano one.
Da, 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 da.
Alto da. Going on, just bass and tenor.
Da, 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 da.
One, two, tenors, here we go, and da.
Da, da, da.
Tenors and altos in the starting in measure 50. Tenor and alto.
Da, 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 da.
One and tenor and
da, alto. Da, da.
Good, and soprano one and two, measure 52. One and ah. One, two, soprano, two. Good. All parts starting back in measure 39.
Thank you. da, da, da.
Section starting in measure 66, first tenors take the lead, then sopranos starting in measure 71 take over the spotlight, and then we get back to all of the contrapuntal things, all of the imitative things. But tenors have the sustained line throughout the little responses of the other four parts there. Let's see. I'd like to just jump to pick up to measure 79. And do tenors and basses. So this is the pickup to the next to last measure at the top of page 9. So tenors and basses. Da, da. One and da. Da, 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 and da. Da, 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 da. And in measure 79, altos and soprano 2. And 1. Da, 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 soprano 2. Da. Good, and that rest that's in there, altos, is just for a really quick breath in measure 90. And soprano 1 and soprano 2 starting in measure 80. And 1. Da, da, da. Back at the very beginning, everybody is standing up. We're going to go right through the whole thing. One and alto. Da. Da, 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 da.
Everybody. And gives us a feel for the whole sense of the piece. It is about 10 minutes of 9. Why don't we just take a minute or two to stretch, stand if you like, move around, and then we will jump back in with When David Heard. Yeah, they, it's very... I'll try to put together a better...
Singing first tenor, first tenor.
All right.
You got my note about David Hurd?
Yes.
When Ted Whalen. We'll sing When Ted Whalen now.
I'm going to start over in measure 40. When David Hurd. We'll start with alto 1 and alto 2. Notice alto 2, you are on the top here. Alto 1, alto 2. 2. Yeah. The when David heard. Probably 2 would be great. Thank you. Alto 1, alto 2. 2, 3, 4. So measure 40, second measure, the bottom of page 5. Alto 1, alto 2, 2, 3, 4. Parts again. 2, 3, 4. Pick up to measure 40 and tenors. 2, 3.
Good. Those two parts again. Starting with sopranos, 2, 3.
Absalom, Absalom, my soul, oh Absalom, oh my soul.
And basses in measure 44, pick up to 45. And
Absalom, Absalom, my son, oh my son. Would God I had died, I had died.
Good. All four parts, starting with sopranos, the pickup to 40, everyone else coming in right at 40. Altos.
Soprano, alto one, alto two.
One, two, soprano, and tenor. Good. Back to 48. 50. Soprano and tenor. So tenors jump in on measure 52 to 53. Soprano, one.
Forward.
And tenor.
Would God I had died for thee. Would God I had died for thee. Absalom, Absalom, my son. Absalom, my son. Oh, Absalom, my son. Oh, Absalom, my son.
Sopranos and basses from measure 50. So sopranos start us off, basses join in the next measure.
One,
two, and
one.
And sopranos, careful in measure 65, E natural there. Altos, 1 and 2. Alto 1, start us off in measure 48. So, would God, beat 2. 1, 2, 3. And 1. Interesting things about the piece is it has this very dark quality because of the text and the story, and suddenly we end in major, which, I mean, it's an interesting choice in illuminating the story. David coming perhaps to terms with what he's experiencing. All five parts, starting in measure 48 with altos, alto 1, then tenors join in, then basses, then alto 2 and soprano. So, second beat of measure 48. 3 and 1.
Absalom, my son.
Slow down just a little bit to set the very final bit. Standing up, very beginning, hold peace. Two, three, alto one. Good. And sopranos, if you need a breath, just taper the sound way down, take a quick breath, jump back in very soft, and bring it back. Have a seat, everybody. All right. One of the things that I really wanted to do tonight was to get us a feel for how some of these things all hang together. As is almost always the case, I've planned more music than we can get to. So we will not make it to the Agnus Dei tonight. In notes, I will, you know, point out some of the things that have we talked about today, as well as the course of the next few rehearsals as we move forward. I know there are some announcements to be made, so I will shut myself up and let them happen. Scoot out of the way.
Yeah, I get to take my mask off. I actually don't have a lot. I noticed that it looks like you all read my notes from this week, the two long emails, and thank you very much for all your help with that. I do want to just bring up again that any information about ads really needs to go through one source. So Bob is our coordinator. Any questions, any information about ads you've sold, whether stuff's coming in, anything, funnel all of that straight through Bob so that he can then keep one spreadsheet, worksheet, whatever he's got going, it's working. And we'd like him to be able to be that point of contact. Thank you to everyone who's gone out and solicited ads for us. Really makes a difference. We really do appreciate it, but please send all information through Bob. I think that's all I had, but I know Bob has announcements. And Linda wants to talk about Skylark, so I don't know who wants to go next. You guys. Okay, Bob, you're up.
Oh. The wire.
Yep.
Hello. We are in the home stretch for our ad campaign. Saturday is the deadline we've given that we'd like to have as many ads as possible that people are going to do back to us, the payment and the actual ad. We have something like 17 ads committed, but I know there are more coming in. I think Nina may have some more information, and Sandra. Again, thank all of you who have been beating the pavement for the ads, and sometimes I know you have to get after people, but I think we're going to have a lot of ads. And Saturday, I will check with Nina and Sandra and try to figure out how many we don't have back yet. And I will let those of you who are doing the ads know if you have someone on your list that we haven't got everything from. We have some money from some of them. Some of them we have the ads, some we have both. But I will send out an email, hopefully on Sunday, saying here are the people that we still need, some the businesses that we still need some more information. And although we set a deadline of the 15th, we can tolerate a day or two extra. As we said before, ads are a very important source of revenue for the chorale chorus. And if any of you have other ideas, there's still time to contact businesses. Some of you may not have volunteered, but there's still time. And so that's the plan, that on Saturday I will see where we stand and let you know if you need to try to get contact again some of the businesses. If you have any questions for me, are there any questions now while we're here? Well, you've got my email, I think, on the list, and my phone number. Feel free to call me if you do have questions or if you have some other businesses you'd like to contact. Thank you.
Oh, so I have information on a really, really easy fundraiser. We've done this one time in the past, a collaboration with a choral group called Skylark, and then COVID. And we actually made a lot of money that year doing this particular program. What they are offering, I have a flyer I will hand out to anybody who's interested. They will, if you are interested in purchasing a subscription to the Skylark season, they're an amazing small chorus. I was the conductor's 10th grade English teacher. I take credit personally. They are great. They will give us 25% back of your subscription cost as a collaborative fundraiser with us. If you already have a subscription, as I do, they will give us 10% for a continuing subscription. So if you're interested, they have a 5-concert season. There's a QR code you can follow. It tells you how to do it with very clear directions. I will hand these out in the back.
Ah. I'm going to say the sign-up is in the back for those who might be interested in caroling at the Festival of Trees on either December, I believe it's 3rd or 4th. I've heard it's on the sign-up sheet. On that back table, as you go out, if you're available and you want to carol at the Festival of Trees, let me know.
And Zoomers, you can put it in the chat if you're interested in Festival of Trees, and I'll collect that chat. That's it, I think. Right. Thanks.
And if you have not had the opportunity to see Skylark, they really are a wonderful ensemble, and their programming is often wonderfully creative. Sometimes it's very standard, but then they sort of break the mold and do some really, really neat things. They did a big Poulenc piece a couple of years ago and interspersed it with folk songs, broke up the movements, which when you first heard it, you thought, well, what is this? But then when you experienced it, was, wow, that really worked. Would not have expected it. So if you are looking for a fun show to go to, even if you don't subscribe, which would be great if you did, because of the fundraising that we get from it, they're worth going and catching an individual show. Yeah, they've been nominated for Grammys, so they really are quite good. And their singers are from all over, but they base themselves out of the greater Boston area. So thank you, everybody, and have a wonderful, wonderful week.
Oh, it's good to see you again.
Thank you very much.
Let's see if we get the right one.
Thank you, sir.
Makes it so much easier.
Oh, I'm glad. I don't get the guy. Thank you.
it's useless.
That's okay.
Yes. Take care of yourselves.
Oh.